The Charlotte Hounds, a goal away from the MLL Championship last year, bring an experienced team to South Florida against the Florida Launch. Both squads are 0-1, so there's desperation mingled in the air with dark clouds. MLL action is coming at you right now. From FAU Stadium on the campus of Florida Atlantic University in Boca, this is Major League Lacrosse. Tonight, the Charlotte Hounds take on the Florida Launch. Hello again, everybody. Along with Kevin Finner, and I'm Dave Lamont. Let me tell you about last week. Home team falls behind in a big hole in the first half. Almost digs their way out of it, but can't overcome it. I don't mean the Florida Launch. Kevin, I mean the Charlotte Hounds. They were down 6-0 at the end of the first period.
Yeah, they came out of the gates not as strong as they would have liked to, I'm sure, especially after going to the championship game against Chesapeake the year before, Dave. So took them a little while to get going on their home turf in Charlotte, you know, going down, as you said, 6-0. But they bounced back a little, but not enough.
The Launch, on the other hand, went into the dressing room at halftime in their first game in South Florida down 11-1. They got within 11-8. But again, too big of a deficit. But this is a little bit of a different Launch team tonight.
Yeah, and we talked to Coach Ross this week, and he said the first half was almost like their training camp because they haven't been together a lot. So, you know, came out strong in the second half. So both teams started out very slowly in both of their opening games, and I'm sure that won't be the case tonight.
All right, let's get right to our Warrior Player Spotlight, beginning with Charlotte.
Well, you look at Mike Sawyer from the Charlotte Hounds, just a dynamic offensive talent. You know, he was held in check a little bit last week with one goal. But coming on into tonight, I'm sure he's going to want to reverse that. Had a great rookie season last year, 13 goals, 6 assists, 6 goals in the playoffs, and brings a 114-mile-an-hour shot to the table. So he's going to be a factor tonight, no question.
And for the Florida Launch, a new face wasn't here last week.
Kevin Crowley is going to be a nice shot in the arm for the hometown team. And Kevin is the reigning MVP, Offensive Player of the Year, Major League Lacrosse All-Star Game MVP. Just a big, strong, athletic, talented, tricky player. And I'm sure he's going to want to get off to a great start with his new team as well.
Some inclement weather in the area. We'll see how it affects our matchup between the Hounds and the Launch coming up next.
It's the greatest assembly of lacrosse talent you will see this year.
Ribble up top. Down a goal for Paul Redd. Run on Kimmel. He scores!
It is Kimmel on the run.
Kimmel for two!
Ridiculous.
From Major League Lacrosse All-Stars, the U.S. National Team, the 2014 MLL All-Star Game, June 26th at Harvard Stadium. Get your tickets today.
Come on, squirrels.
Yo, touch the future, baby.
The Baltimore Bayhawks are the 2002 Major League Lacrosse champions. The Baltimore Bayhawks, champions of Major League Lacrosse. Smith on his way. He scores. The Chesapeake Bayhawks have returned to the winner's circle.
Be a witness to lacrosse history. The 2014 Major League Lacrosse Championship Game, August 23rd, Kennesaw, Georgia. Tickets are on sale now.
How you doing? I'm Scott Rogers, goaltender of the Ohio Machine. The game of lacrosse has given me many opportunities and taught me valuable lessons throughout my playing career. Of all the things I've learned, the most important value I carry with me, on and off the field, is to compete with class. What does that mean? It means playing hard but not dirty. It means obeying the rules and not intentionally injuring others. Because good sportsmanship is so important, I've pledged to compete with class and honor the game this season. Will you join me? Take the pledge at uslacrosse.org/competewithclass.
All right. No, wait a minute. This telecast of Major League Lacrosse is presented by Coca-Cola. Open happiness. By Warrior, proud to be an official equipment sponsor of the MLL. Warrior Lacrosse, cross the line. by Powerade. Power through with Powerade Ion 4. And by 5-Hour Energy, for those who play for the love of the game. And we welcome you to Boca Raton, along with Kevin Finner and Dave Lamont. Weather has been an issue in South Florida. We'll talk more about that in a moment, but let's go ahead and take a look at the goaltender for the Outlaws, Pierce Bassett, who took over in goal in the second quarter of the loss to Ohio last week and was very effective. 57% saves, and the head coach, Mike Cirino, a team that was this close to being the MLL champions last year and losing to Chesapeake 10-9. Brett Queener is back, and we'll hear from him at halftime. He'll tell you about that injury he suffered last week when he took a shot at about 100 miles an hour, he estimates, on the hand. And Stan Ross, with his back to you there, and the hat, is the head coach for the Florida Launch. He talked about how he could just barely, the players barely knew each other a week ago. John Hill, Bruce Crawford, Chris Vahey, and Jody Tyser are your officials for tonight. I mentioned the weather. Humidity, 90%. This is South Florida during what maybe is an early rainy season. And while the skies are broken and gray at the moment, they are expecting thunderstorms close to the end of the game. There was quite a bit of rain in South Florida, all over the state really, most of the day. This field is normally in excellent shape. It is a grass field here, home of the Florida Atlantic Football Owls. Face-off's a big issue for Charlotte last week, Kevin. Talking to Mike Cirino today, he said a big problem, we just didn't have the ball.
Yeah, they want to get off to a good start there. Fallon is taking over for Jeff Snyder. He's not here tonight again, so that's going to be a key factor in the game for them.
And you saw the numbers for Chris Mattis last week, nearly 50%. So it's the Launch in the yellow with a little bit of white and blue, and in the road, whites will be the Hounds.
Looks like they're starting with Casey at attack versus last game they had him at midfield.
And then Casey Powell, who had 2 goals last week, 5 points overall, a strong 3 goals last week, actually. There's a shot and a save and a beauty by Pierce Bassett.
Shot by Grant Thule there, making his first appearance for the Launch as well, out of the Military Academy, United States West Point. Usually an attackman, have him running some midfield there out of the box. It's going to be interesting to see.
Now behind the net, that's Ryan Young out of Maryland, 27. All the way back to Mike Sawyer. If you're not familiar with MLL, there is a 60-second shot clock. Plenty of time left in that. And that arc there is a 2-point line. You make a goal from out there, and you get 2 points. Contact in front, and the ball will belong to Charlotte. Shot clock not resetting. Stopped at 27. Joe Cummings, who had 2 goals last week, being very well marked, gets an opportunity, and it's knocked away. Good defense that time in front by the Launch.
And a smart heads-up slide there, but I think Joe Sinoski is making his Florida Launch debut as well this year, Dave. So he's a real welcome addition to the close defense for the Launch.
Out of Maryland, a big defender, and here are some of the Brian keys to the game. First off, for the Charlotte Hounds.
Well, we talked about face-offs initially there and holding their own while Jeff Snyder's still playing pro indoor. Scoring double-digit goals, you know, they had 4 goals in the second half of the last game. They picked it up. They was held scoreless in the first quarter of that game. And you know, get some good balanced scoring and keep Thule and Kevin Crowley in check. Two guys are going to want to make a factor tonight.
The Launch letting go of a 2-point shot. It goes wide, but it will still be Florida ball. Opportunity there, and that may have been rejected just enough by Bassett to keep it away from the goal. Shot clock stopped at 17. Now it resumes.
Josh Amadon there on that shot, trying to get off early like he did last week.
Amadon had the first goal in Launch history. Opportunity here and a beautiful save. Man, Garrett Thule worked his way right to the front. Bassett saved it, trying to dig it out, and he finally comes away with it.
And Bassett's starting the game this week for Charlotte. Last week, Mike Gable started the game and Pierce finished it. So we'll see how he can come off starting.
And Charlotte's best goalie, arguably, not even here, in Adam Gittleman.
Yes, Adam again has a prior work commitment, coaching, and so that's 2 big losses between him and Schneider.
And there goes Brett Queener. His philosophy is, I'm a lacrosse player, I'm not a goalie. I'd like to see him just go ahead and fire a 2-point shot from there, and now he'll hustle back. You'll hear more about Brett and that unusual style as we take a look for the launch of the Brian Keys of the game.
You know, they were held to one goal in the first half last week and they exploded in the second half for nine. Good balanced scoring. They have two new great additions in Fool and Crowley to their offense, so that should help. And limit turnovers. Utilize his 30-second shot.
Oh, and another great save by Bassett. And the launch got right in front and point blank. He was able to reject that one. So Florida off to a much better start than they were a week ago. They were down to that outstanding bunch from Denver, 11-1 at halftime, before going on a 7-0 run in the second half.
That's why you want to be on your shots right on top of the goalie. And if they can get some more of those opportunities, they'll have a good chance to sink them.
That was a magnificent save. So Bassett has already probably saved two goals for the Hounds. That's Matt White for Charlotte. Working his way around. Dean Gibbons had a touch. And this is Gibbons now, number 12 with it. And to be honest with you, all the launch numbers are a little difficult to read. So we'll do our best to keep up with the Florida players as Queener may have gotten a piece of that shot. And it belonged to Charlotte. Shot clock stopped at only 10 seconds. Going to have to hurry. Opportunity in front. And again, this launch defense, they appear to be a little bit more physical this week.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Tucker Durkin leading the way. And obviously Sanasi coming in and Reed acting another week under his belt with this group. So much improved.
That's Chad Woodson who gives it up to Lo Gosney. And we have whistles. And it'll be a turnover and Charlotte will take over. Take a good look at Kevin Drew out of Syracuse.
Charlotte has some real nice transition midfielders in Watkins and Drew there. And obviously Ryan Flanagan, LSM. So they're going to be a factor tonight.
So once again, you're seeing Gibbons work the back of the net with Ryan Young. And Charlotte resetting with Matt White. Also out there, Jake Trapuka, number 7 in the white. And you see Joe Cummings, 91. Looks like he's trying to post up a little bit. Gets out of the way there, and Queener will chase that one down.
Sawyer trying to unleash his 114-mile-an-hour shot there for two.
I'm sure Brett Queener enjoys that after taking one that he thought was about 100 on his wrist, knocking him out of the game at halftime. He finished out the half last week but did not play the second half, and Adam Fullerton actually stepped in. And at the end of 1 week, he is MLL's number one goaltender. Good pass out there, opportunity for the launch, and they score! The goal by Kayla Cow.
Real nice ball movement by the launch there. As opposed to 1 week ago today, it was in one or two people's stick most of the time. Not a lot of flow, and right off the bat, they had good flow there.
So this time, the launch gets on the board first, and Charlotte is still yet to score in the first quarter in a game this early part of the MLL 14th season. We'll step aside, tell you more about the goal. Launch 1, Charlotte nothing. And this is...
It's the greatest assembly of lacrosse talent you will see this year.
Right up top. Down a goal for Paul Redd. Right on cue. He scores. It is Kimmel on the run. Kimmel for two. Ridiculous.
From Major League Lacrosse All-Stars, the U.S. National Team, the 2014 MLL All-Star Game, June 26th at Harvard Stadium. Get your tickets today.
Out there drives our hard work in here, because the things you do that no one sees determine what happens when everyone's watching.
Seabird's off the sweep, gets inside, it's goal! Change hands, Pennell goes high, scores! Rob Pennell, what a play!
Brody Merrill
for two, and he got it!
Guys, you know they got six packs in the aisles now. Save tons of money.
Save big on six packs of 5-hour energy.
The 2014 MLL All-Star Game will be in Boston on Thursday, June 26. Come out to historic Harvard Stadium and watch a team of Major League Lacrosse All-Stars take on Team USA as they prepare for the World Lacrosse Championships. The game will feature the best players in the world in the most competitive All-Star Game setting you will ever see. Tickets are on sale now at MajorLeagueLacrosse.com. The goal for the launch scored by Kalikau. That is his second of the season. And the assist to Josh Amidon. So he picked up 3 points last week and picks up his first assist this week. And he has 4 points early in the season. And Charlotte winning the faceoff this time. They lost the first one to start the game. But this is a completely different Florida launch team from the almost timid start they had a week ago against Denver.
Yeah, getting off to a good start here. I'm sure Charlotte's going to want to respond. Got the opening faceoff there of Hawkins, so that's going to be helpful. Seems like the flow of the Florida offense, it's more like the second half it was last week.
Yeah, made a great run at Denver last week, but that Outlaw team so good and did not fold under the pressure.
And it's interesting here, Dave. Charlotte definitely has Matt Donowski, number 40, their most potent offensive player playing midfield.
He got off a low shot, and Queener comes up with a save. We were just discussing during the break the difference between a smaller goalie like Queener and a bigger goalie like Pierce Bassett.
Yeah, Pierce takes up a lot of the goal. You know, he's a great communicator out there. You know, so you got to really high to low on him. And then Brett, you know, he's not as big, obviously, but what he lacks in size is quickness and his tenacity is unparalleled.
Launch working behind the net. That's Casey Powell, one of the all-time greats in this sport. Used to pick, looking like he's trying to get off his shot. And a pass in front, and a goal! Powell with a pass, and Benti Quattro scores! A beautiful play by Casey Powell to set up his teammate and fellow coach.
That's exciting play for those two. I'm sure Mario will remember that for a long, long time. Casey goes hard against Brett Schmidt. Double comes a little late, and Mario's right there, point blank on the crease. Carthage High School to Carthage High School, upstate New York.
And both coaches at North Broward Prep in Western Broward County. Casey's the head coach and Benny Quattro's his assistant. That worked out unbelievably well. Benny Quattro's first goal of the year.
Might be his first of his career, Dave.
And Casey Powell, who had 6 points last week, picks up his fourth assist of the season. He just continues to add to his incredible resume. So launch lead 2-0 coming up to the 6.5-minute mark.
That's clear there by Amidon.
Amidon in the back, and again, the savvy and the patience of Powell that time. You knew something was on his brain. He had something in mind.
Yeah, he felt three guys around him. He knew somebody was open. All he had to do was see out of his corner of his eye.
Opportunity in front here for the launch. Oh, and a great rejection that time on the save by Bassett. That was a spectacular save, but the launch will get the ball back. And another opportunity.
Big save by Pierce there to hold it to two.
He's been spectacular so far, and he's had to be.
Pierce had a solid career at Johns Hopkins, just graduating last year. Rookie campaign now.
Through the first 7 minutes, he had already made 4 saves, and you could hear that blistering by.
Another point blank save.
Yep.
Right on top of him. Florida's definitely getting their opportunities early on.
Now, certainly part of the problem of the launch last week was the opponent, a very, very polished Denver team that was ready to go from minute one, but also this is a very different launch team, much more comfortable with themselves.
Charlotte had a good opportunity there in transition. Hawkins just missed that pass. It would have been a point-blank shot. Just got to settle down a little bit, get off the bus. They have the quality talent, leadership. It's surprised if I don't see Danowski going back to attack down the road.
Number 40 in white right now. Problems for Charlotte. You can see the save made in the air that time by Bassett off the shot by Kalikow, who's already scored one for the launch.
Tough shot there, running away from the goal. Really, Pierce could look at that the whole time, made a great save.
And Bassett being a little aggressive that time, a little high on the pass and got away with it. Big shot! And you can hear contact with the poles that time, and coming away with it, the launch goes the other way, and very quickly with Woodson leading the way. Beautiful pass on the hit ahead. Opportunity in front. Shot saved by Bassett. Unbelievable.
Much like Queener was bailing out the launch last week, Bassett seems to be doing that right now.
He has been staggering so far in the first 11-plus minutes of this first quarter. You can just imagine what this score would be if Pierce Bassett, who had a great three-quarters of a game last week. There's a shot. Queener with a catch in the air, and he'll lead the break for the launch. Bassett came in after Michael Gable struggled, gave up 9 goals in 3 periods, made 12 saves, 57% save ratio. Pass got away, and Bassett there to pick up the leftovers.
Florida getting a little sloppy there, last two times down.
Yeah, you got an opportunity here for Charlotte with Cummings. He'll go to John House into the game, number 26. He's being marked by Kalikow. Gets away, though. House with an opportunity to walk right in on goal and missed everything.
John had a solid career at Maryland. The MLL is suited for his midfield-style game.
Dean Gibbons with it. Shot clock, plenty of time, 36 and counting for Charlotte. Coming up to the three-minute mark, the Hounds have yet to score in the first quarter of a game in this young season. They were shut out 6-0 by the Machine. And you see, they haven't got a thing yet. Until now.
Big goal by Matt Danowski.
Matt Danowski coming up with the first goal in the first period, and not at all surprised, a talented attack man from Duke. He did not score last week other than to get an assist. He gets his first goal of the season in the Hounds, thanks in part to Pierce Bassett's goaltending. He cut this lead in half. We'll step aside and return on the Major League Lacrosse YouTube Game of the Week.
The 2014 MLL Championship Game, August 23rd, Kennesaw, Georgia. Get your tickets today.
Yo, touch the future, baby.
The stars of MLL are the most skilled in the world. Chaz Woodson can fly. Paul Rabel can jump over a car. Brad Queener will jump out of one. And last year, Kevin Buchanan brought skeet shooting to the MLL. What will win this year's freestyle competition? Come to the 2014 MLL All-Star Game to help pick the winner. Thursday, June 26th at Harvard Stadium. For tickets and information, log on to MajorLeagueLacrosse.com.
Pierce Bassett has been the man. It's funny, he has stood up to about every shot he has seen. 6 saves so far, Kevin.
Well, this is his first time starting in pro lacrosse, you know, and he's kept the team certainly in it. They're cutting down the angle, hugging the pipe nicely, point blank right in front of the crease, getting the ball up and out. This was a big one right here. You'd have liked to have seen that attackman for Florida go lefty there, increase his angle. And Pierce certainly took advantage of that. Another one right there. Dip and dunk. And he was to the task.
Well, it's so funny because Florida has pretty much dominated the first half. But there you see your score in time. 8 shots for the launch, just 3 for the Hounds.
Yeah, it could clearly be a 5-6-1 game right now.
Now you saw those saves by Bassett, and also it's been a big help that Charlotte has won 2 out of 3 faceoffs. This one still up for grabs and scooping the ground ball. It's the launch. Mattis leading it into the front. That goal by Matt Donowski, unassisted. Opportunity right in front, and missed it. A little bit high that time. Casey Powell, 22, and there's Bassett yet again. Seems like he's had the ball more than anybody else in the game.
And now they're giving some shots where they're just going to keep him hotter and hotter, and you don't want to do that to a goaltender. You want to make for work for every save.
Good patience this time being shown as Matt White, who had 2 goals in the first half last week for the Hounds, number one. .20 on the shot clock. White inside the 2-point line being marked. Lost it. That's some very aggressive launch defense. And Florida comes away with it.
The Lagowski brothers playing LSM together, short stick D midi. Sorry. It's always nice to have two brothers on the same line. You know, they know each other.
The shot, and it's going to miss everything. You can hear it pounding off the boards, and it'll be launch ball. There is Cameron Lagowski, and there's Greg Kalikau, who has one of the launch goals tonight. Shot past the goalie, and the score by Garrett Thole. And the attack man from the Army didn't play last week, has made an impact with his first goal of the season for the launch.
Garrett, such a big presence out there, and you know, all-time leading goal scorer at West Point. He's playing pro now at midfield, and he's going to get that short stick on him. He's certainly going to take advantage as he does that. Rolls back, gets to a strong hand lefty, low to high, top shelf where Grandma hides the cookie jar.
That's also unassisted, as you hear. And a little bit of a holdup here. With 36 seconds to go.
So far, Thole making an impact as we predicted that he would. And, you know, Kevin Crowley still trying to get his feet under him. I haven't really seen him touch the ball that much tonight.
And they're resetting the clock at 45 seconds. And initially it said 36.
Big scrum here. Charlotte needs this ball.
And they do not go. Well, they do get it.
Nice chibe by Hawkins there.
Josh Hawkins out of Loyola.
Doing his job. That's why they're paying the big bucks.
And he takes off as fresh legs come in for Charlotte. Two-point shot, and Queener picks it out of the air right around hip size, goes everything he has, and playing catch with the goalie.
Playing lacrosse tennis here.
And that will be the end of a very interesting first period. That was a big goal by Garrett Thole for the launch. But the man of the match really has to be Pierce Bassett, because his first quarter was spectacular. He kept Charlotte in the game while making 6 saves and facing 9 shots. That's 1 quarter down here in Boca. The launch 3, the Hounds 1.
Hi, I'm Ben Rubio. The game.
Looks like the weather's
bad. Along with Kevin Federer, I'm Dave Lamont, high atop the action here at Boca Raton at the FAU Stadium on the campus in Florida Atlantic. Second quarter about to start. And it is 3-1 launch over the Charlotte Hounds. Both these teams beginning their seasons with a loss at home. Charlotte beaten by the Ohio Machine 15-8. And the Hounds, the Launch defeated by the Denver Outlaws 14-10. Both teams similar starts in their first periods a week ago, falling well behind and then trying late rallies and just not able to catch up.
And these are two really evenly matched teams, and Florida's gotten off to a little bit better start than Charlotte, but Charlotte has the firepower to come back for sure.
Out shooting 10-4, LaLaunch, and again, Pierce Bassett has just been remarkable in goal number 33 in white. LaLaunch in those bright yellows with the white numbers.
Turnover there by Florida. One of the things they wanted to limit on our keys to the game.
We take a look at Jake Smith on defense.
So
Ryan Young there for Charlotte. Sorry about that. Joe Cummings working his way around.
No, so far, Florida's interior defense, close defense, has really held their own. It's almost like, you know, all their offenses seems to be coming from the midfield. For Charlotte, all their movement.
Young again looking for an opening, maybe looking for a teammate to pass to. Can't find anything. Good shutdown opportunity there. It was Tucker Durkin, 51, and a goal right when we're starting to praise the offense. Matt White, his third goal of the season, and the Hounds have pulled within one again.
Matt had a solid game last week, contributing a couple of goals. That's a big one right there. Takes his man behind. Midfielder brings him back to X. I believe he had a short stick there. Yep. Cameron there. Just kept going at him. That doesn't help when you drop your stick. Not sure what happened there.
That is our third straight unassisted goal of the match. And a faceoff awarded to Florida. Faceoff special scamper off, to Charlotte. And another shot, that one's wide. And it will belong to the Hounds. Matt Danowski. He has the first Charlotte goal. Good patience again here by Charlotte. That's back to Ryan Young and all the way out to Danowski.
And again, Matt playing exclusively midfield at this point. Interested to talk to coach at halftime about that.
And a shot blocked by Queener. Gave up the rebound, and Florida comes away with it. And man, the elbows fly on Amadon, who had it and lost it. Danowski's got a chance. He shoots and scores. We're tied up. Man, Amadon got bounced around amongst a trio of Hounds, and coming away with it on the turnover is Danowski, his second goal of the night.
Great offensive rebound by Danowski there, picking the ball up about 15 yards in front of the goal, working hard, protecting it, comes hard to his left side. Looks like he goes five-hole right between Brett's legs.
Leo Gazny, Roman Leo Gazny, was trying desperately to knock the ball loose but could not do it.
Benefit of Matt playing midfield. He's facing the goal on all of his shots. He doesn't come from behind. Doesn't have to take that extra step to greatness. So that's certainly going to help him out.
Well, Charlotte now getting the possessions here. That was a big issue a week ago when they lost to Ohio. Mike Sereno telling us earlier today, we just didn't win enough faceoffs. They didn't even win 40% of them. They're certainly winning more of them tonight.
Yep, Fallon's definitely holding his own. If he's not winning it cleanly, he's getting it out to his wingman. He's got two of the best in Kevin Frew and Josh Hawkins.
There's White working behind the net. Has a chance there with a stick down. Looks like Woodson just plain dropped the pole.
The Charlotte goal scored by number 40.
Should be an unassisted goal for Danowski as well.
Yeah, for sure.
This is the first time we've been tied since the game began. You see right there standing in front, Ryan Young was unmarked, 27 for Charlotte. Four on the shot clock. Mike Sawyer Got to do something with it. And they can't. 60-second shot clock expires.
Big stop. Big stop. First one of the night. 60-second shot clock. Awarded to Florida.
And that time you notice when Queener came out of the net, he was marked. Charlotte was hoping to force a bad pass from the launch goalie, but it didn't happen. Now Florida coming back the other way. Ryan Flanagan on defense.
I'm sure Charlotte knows Brett's a little banged up from last weekend, and they're going to try to take advantage of that.
Yeah, Queener playing. He said all the swelling's gone from his hand. And we'll hear from Brett Queener at halftime, by the way, the launch goalie. And like all goalies, an interesting personality. Chance for Florida went through. And it'll crawl out of bounds and belong to the Charlotte Hounds. No, maybe not. It'll belong to launch.
Tipped out.
Wait a minute, now the official stopping play.
Coach Ross might be contesting that one.
I think it's Mike Serino who's got the argument here, Kevin. I think he's got a feel that should be his ball. But, yep, it's going to belong to the launch, though. No change. And the clock restarts. Under 10 minutes in our half. Big ground ball hit to be picked up here by somebody. And excellent effort by the launch, but Charlotte comes away with it. All the way. Tried to bounce in, did Brett Schmidt, number 44, with the long pole, and just could not control it. Cummings will come away with it, though. Pick it up for Charlotte to start the offense over again.
And Charlotte clearly back in the game, Dave. Everybody touching the ball offensively, defensively, holding their own in front. Transition game as well. And most importantly, pretty much getting every other ground ball that they need to.
Florida began very quickly, but you go back to the effort in goal for Charlotte of Pierce Bassett, who made several point-blank saves to keep this game from getting out of reach. Now the Hounds have found their offense. And the launch gone into a little bit of a shooting slump. That's turned over, though, on a bad pass. It'll belong to Florida, and we will take a timeout. 8:52 remaining in our half. Knotted up between Charlotte and Florida on the MLL YouTube Game of the Week.
Fans, please welcome to the field.
Hi, I'm Ben Rubio. The game of lacrosse has taught me many lessons throughout my playing career. Of all the things that I have learned, the most important value I carry with me on and off the field is to compete with class. What does that mean? It means playing hard but not dirty. It means obeying the rules and not intentionally injuring others. Because good sportsmanship is so important, I have pledged to compete with class and honor the game this season. Will you join me? Take the pledge at uslacrosse.org/competewithclass.
Introducing thelocker.com, a revolutionary new way for athletes to connect off the field. Like, share, collect, and purchase gear right from pros' lockers. Search teams, products, or your favorite players to see what gear they use and trust. Log on today at thelocker.com. What's in your locker?
Major League Lacrosse has changed its postseason format. This year, the top two teams in the standings will host semifinal games August 16th, and the following week, the 2014 MLL champion will be crowned in Kennesaw, Georgia. Come out to Fifth Third Bank Stadium on August 23rd for the championship game and see will host the Steinfeld Cup this year. For tickets and information, all you have to do is go to MajorLeagueLacrosse.com. Stan Ross, head coach of the Florida Launch, with a hat right there, but joined today by Jim Stagnetta, the former coach of the Denver Outlaws. And Jim, big presence on any bench in the MLL.
Yep, Jim took Denver to 14-0 record last year and just had a terrific career over there in Denver. So Florida's lucky to have them on their staff.
Launch in yellow and the Hounds in the road whites, along with Kevin Finner, and I'm Dave Lamont. Thank you for joining us on the MLL YouTube Game of the Week. 0-1 Hounds and the 0-1 Launch. We've been blessed by a lack of rain so far in this game. Humidity very, very high, 90%, as South Florida transitions from its alleged spring season straight into summer.
It's just an exciting game to watch. You know, what you want as a lacrosse fan. Back and forth. Offense, solid defense, solid goaltending.
Yeah, the goaltending has been great for both teams. Andrew Scally for the launch, number 7, had it and lost it. Picked up by Josh Hawkins, and back the other way come the Hounds, and this is Kevin Drew.
Hawkins playing some serious one-on-one defense there. Very physical. Dislodging the ball from Florida, getting possession back for his team.
This is Joe Cummings. He had a couple of goals last week. Shot wide. Trepuka, his father, had a nice little NBA career. Kelly Trepuka played his college ball at Notre Dame. He was part of the Pistons just prior to the Bad Boys. Walking in was Cummings, and Queener got a piece of it. Fighting for it, Ryan Young. You see 27 in white, but it's the launch that comes away with it. And Queener, ever the aggressor, with a pass and a breakout opportunity here for Florida. And they cannot convert.
Great outlet there, but unfortunately the third turnover in a row offensively for the Florida launch.
So what is different? For those who may be just tuning in here, Kevin, Florida began the game just buzzing around the Hounds net. Now, not quite so much. What's different?
Well, I just think they're settling in a little bit, and, you know, they got to continue to go back what was working for them in the first quarter. Better ball movement.
Trepuka posting up, trying to get off a shot, and really didn't have an angle. Cameron Lowe-Gowsney really made that uncomfortable for him, and now back the other way. You can take a look at Brett Queener, the goalie. He might as well take a two-point shot. Queener on the attack.
Fans are loving it.
I don't know if his coach is loving it. Now Queener decides to go back to where he belongs. Although, again, he may feel he belongs right in front of the other net.
Here's Garrett Thule down at the attack end where he's most comfortable.
Thule gets off a shot and another save by Pierce Bassett. That's 11 shots on goal for the launch, and now maybe 7-8 saves for Bassett.
Got a slash on Charlotte here. Florida going to man up here, first time of the night.
Yeah, I was going to say, first penalty. So how do you feel about this approach by Queener?
Hey, you know, at this age, stage of his career, he knows when to go and when not to go. You know, he's going to have the turnovers here and there, but, you know, from what I've seen this season, last season, they're very limited. Brings a lot of excitement and energy to his team, and it's almost like having that fourth midi.
Now you're going to have Casey Powell directing the attack here for the launch from behind the net. And Powell will have it right now. Bente Quattro, who has a goal from Powell. Working it around to Thule. Power play opportunity, first one of the night. Powell on the pass. Shot score! Boy, Casey Powell so patient, and he finds Kevin Crowley. So one of the newcomers and your key player of the game for the launch picks up the goal, and Powell picks up the assist.
Textbook man-up play. Everybody touching the ball for a second, moving along, getting the defense moving. Kevin Crowley point blank. He's going to rip that every time. Great heads-up pass by Casey Powell.
Well, that's two assists for Powell tonight. He's got 8 points already this season, and Kevin Crowley, who did not play last week, picks up his first goal. That's a devastating combination for the launch.
That's got to feel good for Kevin Crowley. His first goal with a new franchise. I'm sure that he's exciting.
And Manis comes away with a faceoff, and quickly off of that momentum, the launch already putting a little pressure on Charlotte's defense. Grant Kalikow now in the position that Powell was occupying earlier. Woodson. Lefty shot. missed everything, as you can hear. But the launch will take over.
Good take by Chaz there, trying to score his first goal as a member of the Florida launch as well. Nice split right to left.
Vinny Quattro directing the attack. Gets a pick from Powell. Looks like they were trying to maybe get to Venti Quattro again, but instead it'll be Powell. Not a bad place to have the ball.
Trying to work a two-man game behind.
Goes long instead. We have not had a two-point goal yet so far. That's way high on the effort there by Kayla Cow. Take a timeout. Florida has gone back in front. The Hounds have never led in this game. But they have fought back of deficits every single time. We'll see if they can do it again on the MLL YouTube Game of the Week.
Fans, let's see you make some noise.
To be the hero in front there. Whoa! He fires and scores! The Long Island Lizards jumping for joy. Victory in 2003. A national championship, if you will, for the Toronto Nationals. The champions are from Chesapeake. You can believe in the Bayhawk dynasty.
Who will be next? The 2014 MLL Championship Game, August 23rd, Kennesaw, Georgia. Get your tickets to... Assembly of lacrosse talent you will see this year.
Rabel up top. Down a goal for Paul Red. Right on cue. He scores. It is Kimmel on the run. Kimmel for two. Ridiculous.
The Major League Lacrosse All-Stars. The U.S. National Team. The 2014 MLL All-Star Game. June 26th at Harvard Stadium. Get your tickets today.
There's your score. With the launch in front of Charlotte, 4-3. Let's correct that. And take us through here, Kevin, the goals for Florida so far.
Nice cut by Grant Calicao, starting out the scoring for the launch there. And then Powell head up, brings three men to him, finds Kevin Aquato scoring his first pro career goal. And then Garrett Thule, low to high, gets his hands free, he's gonna rip it every time. And then Powell, a nice feed for Kevin Crowley, his first goal in a cut on man up as a member of the Florida launch.
So once again, the launch back in front. They have never trailed in this game. They've been tied, obviously, 0-0 and then 3-3. So we'll see if the Hounds can do what they've been forced to do so far all evening here in the second game of the season for these two MLL teams. Come from behind. In fact, I'm beginning to think, Kevin, I don't have it right in front of me, that Queener able to make a great save there on the shot by Josh Hawkins, and I don't think Charlotte's had a lead yet this season. They trailed the entire match against the Ohio Machine. They were stunned at home at Memorial Stadium in Charlotte, 15-8. Strong start for Ohio. And now they trail in this one, 4-3.
Yep.
That's his house. Shot wide. Good marking that time by the launch.
Getting some good shots off now. Just got to bury them. You know, they need some more scoring, too. Of the three goals, Danowski's got two of them.
Eight shots on goal for Charlotte, 12 for Florida. Working behind the net again. There's a tough shot, taken from a rough angle by Cummings. Shot clock stopped at 21. Smothering defense that time by the launch, no flag down. It looked like Tucker Durkin, who just basically swallowed Ryan Young.
The refs are letting them play. It's 2 weeks in a row we've had limited amount of penalties.
You okay with that?
I am. I think so. I think it's better for the game. As long as they're not out of control, putting players in a position to get hurt, let them play.
So the launch being extremely patient here with the ball. Roman Laugowski had it. Florida waited to get the right group they wanted out there. That's Kevin Crowley with it now. Crowley being marked by Cittadino and tried a wraparound shot. Cittadino did a good job, just basically blew him up. Defender from Towson University in the Baltimore area. Quickly comes back the launch. And point-blank opportunity blocked again by Bassett. And they are getting very physical, and you do wonder at what point will we see a flag.
Great move by there by Powell. Again, right on the doorstep, and Bassett comes up big.
How many times Casey Powell gets rejected at the front door by anybody?
Yeah, he didn't have a lot of angle there to shoot at, so Pierce knew that, hugged the pipe. Opportunity to shoot five-hole, and he gets there, and he gets correct.
Dean Gibbons making the spin move, getting in front and scoring over Queener. Dean Gibbons from Harvard has tied the game with a minute 15 remaining in the half.
Goal. Like to see this one on replay there.
This will be his first goal of the year.
Dean went hard there on Reed Acton. Pushed in. Yep.
Charlotte goal.
Shot got scored. Off before he landed in the crease. Before his foot was in unassisted. The crease.
Another unassisted goal. We've had a bunch of those. That'll be five of our eight goals unassisted. So with 75 seconds remaining in the half, this game complete suspense awaiting us in the second half. Good job on the faceoff by Fallon. He's had a good half doing his job. Now, do you consider milking the shot clock here and trying to get off one late and giving Florida very little opportunity, or do you just fire away?
No, I think they're going to go at him. I think they're going to go at him. They got Sawyer playing a lot of midfield as well, who's typically an attackman. So between him and Donowski, should have an opportunity to get some shots off here.
Trebucha posting up, lost it. Opportunity, a vicious shot taken by Sawyer that missed everything. Down to 39, 40 seconds with the clock stopped.
Advantage of that, you have two short sticks playing at midfield versus three long poles close. So guys like Donowski and Sawyer can take advantage of that.
Ryan Young retreating almost out of the stadium, it looked like for a second there. Now Cummings, shot clock at 15. Cummings working his way close in front, really being marked this time. Clobbered, as a matter of fact. 17, shot clock at 4. He's going to have to lob something out of bounds. That's exactly what happens. So excellent defense by the launch, but let's see if Queener can try another one of his long-distance throws. And does. Well, that was a beauty. Maybe one last shot here for Florida in front, and it hit the side of the net. That was Kalika who had one last opportunity, but appropriately, Pierce Bassett kind of blocked that edge of the goal. What a great half he had. Well, we're going to get to hear the life of a goalie from Brett Queener when we return. Halftime here, 4-4, Charlotte and Florida on the Major League Lacrosse YouTube Game of the Week. But before we step aside, Stan Ross is joining us. And Stan, this is a vastly different first half than last week. What is different about your team in the first half from last week?
I can't hear you.
Can you hear us a little bit better now?
Is this I can hear you a little bit better now.
All right. I'm just asking about the difference in your team from a week ago. They look much sharper and much more together. All right, All right.
Can't hear anything.
Okay, thank you, Stan. We appreciate that. We apologize for the technical problem. We'll try to correct that at halftime. And we'll hopefully be able to talk to Coach Ross on the way out or maybe Coach Serino. Again, we will step aside, and you'll hear from goaltender Brett Queener when we return. We're at halftime here, the battle between the Charlotte Hounds and the Florida Launch, week two of season 14 of Major League Lacrosse. Inside on this rainy day, joined by Launch goaltender Brett Queener. And first off, you're playing, which is great news, because a week ago we saw you come out at halftime with your arm about up to here following a nasty shot. What happened?
I just took a shot, probably 100-mile-an-hour shot in my hand. The reason why I was up just is to take away the swelling, but swelling went away, and I'm good to go this week. So
you have no trouble going back in there again and facing more 100-mile-an-hour shots?
There's obviously something wrong with me.
The first week obviously didn't quite go as planned. Tough start in particular, but in the second half, the Launch gelled and nearly pulled off a rather miraculous comeback. What were the difference between those two halves?
We scored one goal in the first half, and then we scored nine in the second half.
Specifically, how did you score those goals, besides getting them past the goalie?
I think that they threw them, and then the ball flew in the air and then went in the net instead of the other goalie stopping them.
You ever feel sorry for the other goalie?
Never.
You ever expect them to feel sorry for you?
No.
In this town, lacrosse is growing all the time. You've heard that. You come out of Syracuse, where it has been a big deal for a long time. What do you think it'll take to grow the sport in South Florida?
Well, I think this is a great first step, having a professional franchise, first ever professional franchise in this county. So that right there is a great first step. And having guys, ambassadors of the sport like Casey Powell, Chaz Woodson, Mario Vinicuaccio, Doug Shanahan, guys like that that are in the community, Stan Ross, our head coach, guys that are in the community, and then showcasing this great sport that we play at the professional level at such a great venue, and hopefully the kids get out, the families get out, and they support it, and then rally around it. And if we can give them some wins and some good lacrosse to see, then I think that will just be another stepping stone in the eventual growth of the sport down here.
Let me go back for a second about your career choice. Why goalie? And did you try the other positions? Did you find you just had the knack for goaltending?
Yes, I've actually played professional at every position. So in college, I played man up. When the team would get a penalty, I would go down and play man up. I just had the opportunity to play varsity lacrosse as an eighth grader as a goaltender, and found that I was good at it and stuck with it, and picked up the positions wherever I could on my journey. And so I don't consider myself a goalie. I consider myself a lacrosse player.
Going to say, speaking of journeys, you take journeys when you get the ball and go out of your area, you'll go a long way. Yep. We were joking on the broadcast last week that you were just trying to get a little exercise, but there is more to it than that.
Yeah, I like the fact that you use the word journey and not adventure. So, that I think this
I'll
is
leave that for the coach.
Yeah, very good point. And for me, it's I think it's a difference maker from setting myself apart from other goaltenders in the league. And so it automatically gives us an extra man in transition, gets us out, gets us running, and hopefully sparks a transition goal or two along the way. And I don't give up the ball and give up an empty two-pointer. So.
Well, I was going to say, have you been burned by that? Has it ever gone and flipped on back?
Never. Never once.
Didn't think so.
Never once.
There's probably no evidence of that anywhere to be found.
Yeah.
Where did you come up with that idea? I mean, was that just something that was born out of, I'm going to try this, or how?
My college coach at Albany, Scott Marr, great mind for the game. And, my first ever Division I game, we were playing Johns Hopkins, and we had three foul clears in the first quarter, and he said, Brett, run. So I've kind of been running ever since.
All right, we take a look at the Florida Launch for the year. Knowing how this league is going to change and how this team is going to change, how do you forecast the future for this year's team?
Well, we're going to find out tonight. And hopefully, at this point right now, hopefully we had a great first half. I think it's just getting everybody together and putting the ball in the net and getting stops on defense, picking up ground balls. It's a simple game. If you do the little things and do them correctly, then you're going to win. But that's what it comes down to.
Easier said than done sometimes. But the other thing I find interesting about your position is, you look at hockey, a good goals against average is about 2. Here it's about 10, which you were able to accomplish near that last year. I mean, knowing that you're going to get burned, how do you deal with that when, okay, I gave up a goal?
It's confidence after failure. The ability to block that out and go on to the next one. I've been hitting the head a lot over my career, so being able to forget things comes natural for me. But that's a huge part of it. The best goalies in the world save it at a 55 to 60% ratio. So that means you're failing 45 to 40% of the time if you're the best. So the ability to move on is paramount. And for me, that how I work on that is just by focusing on my breathing, and you know, you in and out, and just kind of get refocused every whistle, and you know, hopefully your teammates support you, because there's no goalie out there that can do it on his own. Just it's kind of like the way that quarterback is the most dependent position in football. Goalie is the most dependent position in lacrosse.
Well, one of the best joining us here, Brett Queener. Brett, thank you for the time. We'll get you set for the second half when we return. Major
Hi,
League
Mom.
Lacrosse.
Hi, Dad.
You're welcome. Charlotte
Hi,
and the Florida Lunch.
Hi, Dad.
Along with Kevin Finner and I'm Dave Lamont. Halftime festivities wrapping up. Teams are on the field. The Charlotte Hounds and the Florida Launch tied at four. And the Hounds, Kevin, got off to another slow start, but kept in the game by the great goaltending of Pierce Bassett before they finally unleashed their offense.
Yeah, and it started with Matt Donowski swinging down the left lane there, sticking it, coming back with Matt White, going one-on-one against a short stick. Tough to defend there, no slide. Big-time ground ball by Donowski. Buries it five-hole on Queener. And this last goal here, Cummings. Individual great effort by him. Tie it up.
Now the Launch gone off very quickly, unlike last week.
Big look there. Nice cut by Calico, stuffing it in there. That's that shot again. Good movement off ball. Second goal, Powell goal, driving hard to the goal, keeping his head up, finding Vantu Quattro for his first goal as a pro. Fool, low to high, taking advantage of the short stick, and then a man up goal, Kevin Crowley, first professional goal as a member of the Florida Launch.
So that's where we stand right here. Casey Powell with two assists, Kevin Crowley with that one goal there. Charlotte outscoring Florida 3-1 in the second quarter, whereas Florida did the same them in the first. There we stand. Stats, shots on goal, the Launch with 13, the Hounds with 11. And faceoffs right now, Charlotte with the advantage, 6 out of 10 have gone their way. And one of the Launch goals on the only power play we've had all night. Very physical game, particularly I thought the last 4 or 5 minutes of that second quarter, the defenders were definitely getting their shots in.
Yeah, the refs are letting them play. It's like a good old, you know, brouhaha. And, you know, we'll see what team can come out, start fast here, and they go on a run. It's going to be tough for the other team to come back. Or we could be talking about a, you know, 9-9 game with 1 minute to go in the fourth quarter.
Well, a definite impact being made today by Tucker Durkin, Garrett Thule, rookies in MLL playing their first game for the Launch, and Fallon wins another faceoff. That's 7 of 11 so far, and that was a big problem last week when the Hounds lost to the Ohio Machine 15-8 in their opener. Charlotte in the road white, the Launch in the bright yellow with the white numbers, and a shot, and Queener rejects that right away. The shot taken by Josh Hawkins, and back comes Florida.
Always want to get that first stop of the half as a goalie. It's a big one.
Powell looking for an opening. Goes to the top. Here's a chance at a goal. Josh Amadon, his second goal of the season. Powell may pick up an assist on that one. Also a great pass from the top of the key. And Florida retakes the lead.
Florida got Charlotte napping in transition there. Took advantage of the numbers. Nice high to low shot. Josh Amadon. That's what you teach kids. Textbook.
So in the first 34 seconds, Florida regains the lead. That for Amadon is his team best third goal of the season. He's got 5 points, make it 6 points now on the year.
Launch goal scored by number 22.
Two in a row for Charlotte there in the draws there, Dave, in the faceoffs.
Well, they've announced the goal for Casey Powell, but I thought that was Amadon.
I have to look at it again. I'm pretty sure it was Amadon as well.
Lau Gosny getting an assist on that pass. I am pretty sure that was the goal for Florida, scored by Amadon.
I believe Casey got the second assist, the hockey assist on that one.
I was going to say, if they give a hockey assist, Casey Powell definitely deserves that. But we'll double check. This is Joe Cummings. He fires, and Queener put up the stop sign there. Quickly, Matt White hustling over for the Hounds. White being checked on the post up, tried to go behind the head. And it almost worked. It bounced just by the wide of the goal and chased down by Ryan Young. Shot clock, plenty of time left here, 45 seconds.
Here's Sawyer playing midfield, accustomed to attack usually. Interesting setup between him and Donowski playing most of the night, if not the whole night, at midfield.
And a missed opportunity. You can see White thrusting his head in the air in frustration. So Jake Trepuka on the attack. Lost it. Lost everything there for a second. Trepuka works his way in and hit the side of the net and took a tough spill,
Gotta
too.
Got to be a crease call there.
Yeah. And Brett Queener trying to help him up. I'm not sure anybody who's a trainer who may be watching this game would have suggested that. But Trepuka hopefully we'll be able to walk this one off.
Injury timeout.
And there is an injury timeout taken. We've been very, very fortunate. We're taking another look at Trepuka here and see what happened. Jocenoski marking him.
Just tough defense by Joe, making his mark in his first game as a member of the Florida launch.
That's just a hard fall when you don't expect it.
Yeah, guys usually bounce right back up, so we definitely got him in a spot where he's not accustomed to, lower back or somewhere in that area.
Yeah, he may ask for an extra pillow on the flight back to Charlotte for his back. I was going to mention that we've been fortunate that the weather has held off. If folks in the South Florida area took a pretty good dosing of rain during the afternoon, we are expecting rain near about the end of the game. And we're hoping it'll hold off, because if there's lightning and a goal! And coming through, well, there's no surprise to see Casey Powell. He's had a couple of assists, credited incorrectly with a goal. Now he has a goal.
Great ball movement by the launch. Crowley draws a double, banks it over to Cunningham. Powell off cut, off ball cut. Hawkins a little slow to get on him. Real good, nice quick stick, bury the...
That's four goals for Powell. 9 points already. We haven't even finished two games yet. And again, I don't know why they haven't changed that. We're pretty sure Amadon, and we know we'll get an opportunity to look at it again. Maybe we're wrong. I hope not. Yeah, we're getting confirmation that it's Amadon, so I guess we just need to get it straightened out with the PA announcer. Thank you to Norm, our producer, for pointing that out. So it's nice to be right every once in a while.
Sort of like the beginning of the first half as well.
Yep.
Florida came out strong. Charlotte struggling to get in the game again.
You see Sawyer. Yeah, that's an excellent point, Kevin. This is if you're just joining us and wonder what the game was like and saw it was 4-4. It was in the first quarter. The launch dominated, outshot Charlotte 9-3, but it was Bassett's brilliance and goal. Walking right in here is Donowski, and he throws it away. Woodson comes away with it. But it's Bassett and goal who just saved the day for the Hounds. And that still sits on the scoreboard. Florida could easily be in double digits by now. And that's Powell with that patience. There's Andrew Scally out of St. Mary's. Played well last week. Thinking about a shot here, but being checked by Hawkins. Woodson. Good job there by House to not bite for the fake, and the shot skirts through the crease and goes out of bounds.
Good take there by Chaz. Trying to score his first goal this season for as a member of the Florida launch.
21 on the shot clock for Andrew Scally. Looking into the middle, that's marked off. And just picked by Brett Schmidt.
Great individual defense by Schmidt there. Now running the floor. They got numbers in transition.
Opportunity here and high on the shot. You could see the force behind that effort, but it just didn't work.
So far on difference in this half, Florida shooting better than Charlotte. Getting the opportunities, not making them count.
You get a good look at Dean Gibbons, the attacker out of Harvard. This is White looking to the middle, and Queener interrupted what might have been a pass to Cummings. Great job there by Queener to anticipate that.
Brett bailing out his defense there. Lost in translation there on the communication part.
Opportunity here for Florida. Almost virtually unmarked. And now resetting will be the launch.
Charlotte needs a big play either offensively or defensively to get that energy level up to where they want to be.
That was Kayla Cow to Powell, 22. Powell, one of the number two all-time scoring in MLL coming into this season, and he is on an unbelievable pace already this year with 9 points. Crowley lost control of the pass.
Crafty little pass inside there.
Yep. Crowley trying again. Haven't seen anybody try a two-pointer yet. And stolen. Beautiful job by Casey Cittadino, the defenseman from Towson, and he gets help.
Casey's a wily veteran. He's been playing Dean Mitty in the pros for a number of years. Great career.
Opportunity here for the Hounds. Working it around, and Queener comes up with a save on the shot by Gibbons.
Wow, he makes it look easy. He really does. He's just in a position, correct position at all times. And when he has to be acrobatic, he can do that as well, but just plays the angles perfectly there. Didn't even have to move, really just hit him.
So, Charlotte will load up once again. These teams lost their opening games, both of them at home. In both similar fashions, Charlotte and Florida fell into deep holes against good opponents and could not come from behind. On the charge here is Sawyer. Passed up the pass in the middle. Danowski being very well marked. And the launch come away with it. Their defense sturdy.
Solid interior defense there. Matt Danowski looking for the guy on the crease. Just clamped down on him.
So now Casey Powell will run the attack from behind the net. As the launch now being very patient, Venti Quattro, who has a goal tonight. As Kevin mentioned, his first professional goal. Looking maybe now to pick up his first professional assist. Shot from the left side coming up. Nope, pass instead.
Big Grand Thule there.
Charlotte cutting off the angles right now. Behind the net, shot clock running down to four. Going to have to try something. Powell, and up, shot clock violation. And, you know, where his head was angled, he could probably see that shot clock, too.
Yeah, he was trying to dive in there. I was watching his body language. He just couldn't get the right angle.
A good defensive stand by the Hounds that time. 6:40 remaining in our quarter. It was tied at the half at four. Florida's picked up two goals here. By Amadon, they've changed it now on the score sheet, and by Casey Powell. And Lau Gosney got the only assist on that other goal, so they did not give Powell the hockey assist. Good move by Trepuka, who's more than healthy as he comes back with a very clever move and could not score, though, as once again, Queener, for a small guy, has stood tall in goal. Get a good look at Tucker Durkin, 51 for the launch, making his debut tonight for this team, and he has played very well, marking right now. On Ryan Young, and that shot no good. Correct myself, Durkin was on the field last week. There have been some personnel changes for the launch. Most notably, Kevin Crowley, who has scored.
Here's Sawyer back out to his normal position at attack. Got a shorty.
Oh, so what is the difference here? Charlotte showed some life in the second quarter, Kevin, with three goals so far and nothing.
Yeah, they're not hitting the goal. Their shooting percentage is very poor here. And when they are, Brett's bailing out Florida.
Except for right there is Mike Sawyer in perfect position. Took the high pass and gets it past Queener for his first goal of the night.
Charlotte goal.
That's clearly you want to be. If you're Sawyer right on top of the crease, and that's where he was, and got a great feed from behind and buried it. Not much that Queener could do there.
His second goal of the season, 3 points on the year for Sawyer. Will return in a moment. This is the MLL YouTube Game of the Week.
Like speed? Check out the MLL All-Star Game Fastest Shot Competition.
Topped it, 114.
Can anyone top 114? Find out at halftime of the 2014 MLL All-Star Game. Thursday, June 26th at Harvard Stadium. For tickets and information, log on to MajorLeagueLacrosse.com.
Come on, squirrels, all in. Get the ball. Come on. Yo, touch the future, baby.
Meets Lahackett cleanly. Smith on his way. He scores.
the Chesapeake BayHawks have returned to the winner's circle. Time expires. It's official. Chesapeake, number one. The champions are from Chesapeake. You can believe in the BayHawk dynasty.
The 2014 MLL Championship Game, August 23rd, Kennesaw, Georgia. Get your tickets today.
Fans, get ready for your MLL weekend by watching Inside the MLL, presented by Coach of the Week by expert analysts as well as MLL players and coaches. Watch Inside the MLL, presented by Coke, on CBS Sports Network all summer long. Take a look at Mike Sawyer scoring from Ryan Young at 9:32 of the third, and so the Hounds, who have yet to lead this season. However, Florida cannot pull away, and the Hounds are right with them again, 6-5.
In our player spotlight, Ryan Young and also Sawyer, obviously, two attackmen that used to play together, are used to playing together at attack position, now back in that familiar position together.
Charlotte with the edge in shots on goal, 16-15, and certainly with the edge in faceoffs, 9 out of 13 faceoffs tonight for the Charlotte Hounds. Last week, they only hit on 37% of their faceoffs.
Right, and another key of our game, and Fallon stepping up to do his job.
Now Trepuka on the run, and instead of shooting, he decides to go ahead and reset it back with Ryan Young, just fresh off that assist. Shot there, did not connect from Matt Danowski, who didn't score a goal last week, much to everybody's surprise. Ryan Young, I think, was that 20 games in a row that he's had at least a point?
I believe so, Dave, yep.
You can subscribe to our channel, MLL channel, at youtube.com/MLL. We suggest you do so to keep up on all the teams and on these games of the week that we are so proud to present to you. Shot on goal there, a little bit high, so the launch trying to return to their offensive form. Been close all night. Largest lead for the launch has been 2. No lead yet for Charlotte. Oh, behind the back. Very clever, but it didn't work. That was Powell. This is Kevin Cunningham. Opportunity in the middle, dropped. Ground ball picked up by Florida. Oh, what a shot! Making something out of nothing is Grant Kalikow.
Crafty, right on top of the crease, goes sidearm. Doesn't have much time to shoot. He'll take what he got, and he buries it. Big goal, because Danowski and Charlotte definitely had some momentum going there. See the pass initially is missed. Picks it up, sticks with it. Crafty inside attackman. Off the pipe and in.
He looked like he was shoveling something, and did. He shoveled in his second goal of the night. Grant Kalikow gives the launch another 2-goal lead.
It's the greatest assembly of lacrosse talent you will see this year.
Riddle up top. Down a goal for Paul Redd. On cue. He scores. It is Kimmel on the run. Kimmel for 2. Ridiculous.
The Major League Lacrosse All-Stars. The U.S. National Team. The 2014 MLL All-Star Game. June 26th at Harvard Stadium. Get your tickets today.
Hard work out there drives our hard work in here. Because the things you do that no one sees determine what happens when everyone's watching.
Seabird's off the sweep, gets inside, it scores! Change hands, Pennell goes high, scores! Rob Pennell, what a play!
Brody Merrill
for 2, and he got it!
What is focus? It's a wondrous sensation of clarity and alertness. It's owning your opponent. It's knowing beyond a doubt you got this. It's keeping your head down, your eye on the ball, and knocking it out of the park. It's getting in the zone. It's keeping on your toes, on target, on top. Focus is staring the world in the face and saying, bring it. Focus is power. Focus is life. And 5-Hour Energy is focus.
Next week, Major League Lacrosse on YouTube comes to you live from Boston as the Cannons host the Denver Outlaws. That'll be Saturday night at 6 o'clock Eastern. The only place to see this game is right here on YouTube for live games each week, as well as exclusive Major League Lacrosse video content. Visit youtube.com/MLL to subscribe to the official MLL YouTube channel. You see our scoring time also around the league tonight. With about 8 minutes left in the third quarter, Chesapeake leading the Lizards 9-5. And a big game last night that you had a chance to watch.
Yeah, Boston playing up in Rochester, and Rochester coming away with a one goal, pretty much of an upset, you know, most people would say.
And you see a holding call, and that's going to go against the launch. Tim Fallon helping our referee with that call. Also tomorrow in the league, a very interesting matchup in altitude, Ohio at Denver, both winners against these teams, as a matter of fact, the week one. And it's Star Wars Uniform Day in Denver. So you might want to check your Twitter feed if you follow the Denver Outlaws and take a look at those uniforms. Low shot, Queener got a piece of that.
It'll be interesting to see if Ohio can sustain what they accomplished last weekend against an incredibly talented Denver organization.
The home opener for the Outlaws who came here. That's a disadvantage there, and a shot goes wide. Picked up, Queener on the check, knocking it away from White. Ryan Young actually faked Woodson out of his stick for a moment. Now Dean Gibbons on the attack for the Hounds.
I think either the last 10 shots have either been sidearm, behind the back, between the legs.
What, does that indicate good defense or just some creative shot making?
I think it's more, you know, good defense, but little more fundamentals offensively needed both teams.
Danowski and Sanoski battling. And back come the Hounds again. Cummings being worked over pretty good. Over to Young in front. They were trying to get it to Danowski, who was just run down in what has been a very physical game. The shot clock, you see the signal from the official, meaning to reset the 60-second shot clock.
And again, the refs really letting him play tonight, Crawford and his crew.
We've had just one penalty, that on Ryan Young for slashing, and Florida took advantage and scored the power play goal in the second quarter, their only goal of that quarter. So Joe Cummings on the attack, working it around to Sawyer. Now we're seeing everybody for Charlotte get involved here as they try to crack a launch defense. It's only given up one goal in this quarter. Opportunity here, though. Shot score! Matt White able to find Joe Cummings, and Cummings, who had two goals last week, is on the board for the first time tonight. 7-6.
That was overall pretty good defense. Florida slid initially, tried to recover, and in time they didn't get it over to Cummings. Matt White made a great pass over to his teammate of 2 years.
So White has a goal and an assist. Scored by number 9. Can't imagine him not getting the assist there. And he does.
Again, that wasn't very poor defense. It was just better offense. Big faceoff here.
You know, 11 of 15 in favor of the Hounds. Make it 12 of 16. That's amazing.
We talked about one of the keys of the game, and it's certainly holding up to that end of the bargain right there.
Almost out of bounds, almost a bad turnover, but Michael McCormick trying to scramble here, and he lost it. Casey Powell pleading with the official. He's not at all pleased with what just happened there.
Not sure what that call was.
And neither is Casey, by the way. Under a minute now in this quarter. Again, Charlotte has not led in this game. They have been tied twice, one of them, of course, being at the start of the game. Can they tie it up again? Maybe we'll see a two-pointer. We have not seen, I don't think we've even had an attempt yet.
I think Danowski has one.
We haven't had one go in.
No, he had six last year.
And that would tilt things significantly. There's a shot, and Queener might have gotten just a little piece of that. Shot clock is off.
Again, down low, when Sawyer plays behind, he gets a shot off that much more. Natural position.
That's Trepuka. You see the time left in the quarter. Down to 13. Trepuka being marked. He's got to find some help unless he tries to wrap around. He does and scores! With 5 seconds remaining, the Hounds have come back from another two-goal deficit and have tied the game in the third quarter.
Excellent call on your Dave, on your part, Dave. That's exactly what he had. He took advantage of what he had. No slide was coming. One-on-one with a short stick. Rocked them back to the left, came back to his right, and stuck at top shelf. Sorry, low shelf.
That's unassisted, and his second goal of the season. So we are, barring a miraculous effort here, going to go into the fourth quarter tied. Mattis wins the faceoff, and that's the end of the quarter. Well, what a match. Tied at halftime, and now tied after three. The Hounds in the launch, trying to get their first wins of the season. We'll take a look at the fourth quarter when we return on the MLL YouTube Game of the Week.
So it's time for our Cascade Under the Helmet, and I thought it would be a good idea to talk about some of the rookies in this class. Not I. Let me, you know what? I don't want to take any credit for that, Kevin. But as we start the fourth quarter, certainly some of the rookies for Charlotte from last year.
Yeah, sophomores, guys, players right now, Sawyer, led by Sawyer. And Tripucu just had that big goal. Okay, and Matt White, obviously, and Josh Hawkins, who can do it both ends as a defensive midi and isn't as offensively as a threat as well.
That is our Cascade Under the Helmet. He's Kevin Finner, and I'm Dave Lamont. We're about to start the fourth quarter of what has been a fantastic MLL YouTube Game of the Week. In yellow, the Florida Launch. In the white, the Charlotte Hounds. Both teams losers in the first week of the season, not playing like losers tonight. This has been an intense game. You got a pretty good look at it right there, what this game has been like. As Ryan Flanagan comes away with it for Charlotte, and he runs into trouble but got away with it as Josh Hawkins is on the run.
Great ground ball by Ryan Flanagan there. Just a wily veteran and going over his back, finding Josh Hawkins. Big possession there.
Charlotte with a ground ball advantage at the end of the three quarters, 15-13. But it's been that kind of game. Everything is close. Shots on goal are close. Saves, of course, are close. Ground balls are close. The only stat that where any team has a huge advantage is faceoff. Charlotte has won seven more faceoffs than the Launch. Cummings. A little threat in that two-point line from Sawyer. He'll fire it, and it goes wide.
Good defense there. Really not giving Sawyer his time for time and room. Hands-free shot.
Shot there. Excellent defense that time by Tucker Durkin, who's played well for the Launch. You can follow us on Twitter, by the way. Want to keep up with all the teams? See those Star Wars uniforms that are being broken out tomorrow in Denver at MLL_lacrosse.
Florida defense holding them really well there, almost forcing it pretty much of a turnover on the shot clock. Need a good possession here.
Well, they turn to Casey Powell. There he is. Powell having his typically impressive outing.
9 points already on this young season for Casey Powell. Oh, what an amazing shot! Garrett Thule! Looked like he actually used the defender as a bit of a screener to get that in on the launch, retake the lead. And for Thule, that's his second goal of the night.
He just lulls him to sleep, takes Casey Cittadino down the right wing there, makes him think he's going to go hard righty, baits him a little bit of an overcommit, and then comes back with that lethal lefty shot that he's been doing for years.
Wow, that was spectacular. So two goals on the season, two goals on the game. And again, just one of these little weird stats, Kevin, that I probably have talked a little bit about. Charlotte still hasn't led in a game so far in 1 3/4. Big ground ball here, and the launch will maintain it briefly. What a spectacular effort. And here comes Florida the other way on the attack. Leo Gosney just inside the two-point line. You can hear that shot blistering off the boards wide. Florida picking up. There's a two-point attempt and save made by Pierce Bassett. Turned over.
Fell trying to put a dagger right there with a two-pointer.
No, we haven't had a three-goal lead in this game yet. Humid conditions tonight. Humidity around 90%, so you wonder about conditioning and whether or not that's going to be a problem.
Illegal pick there. They don't usually call that.
They haven't called a lot of things tonight, but that one they did call. Back the other way. There's just inside the two-point line, the long shot taken by Brett Schmidt. And it'll belong to the Charlotte Hounds, under 12 minutes remaining in regulation.
Charlotte right there.
Danowski.
It's going to go through Matt, that's for sure.
Number 40 in the white. One of the top players in MLL, little question of that. That's John House. House gets away off the spin move, but runs into trouble. Flag is down. Well, we haven't seen many of those today. This will just be the second, and it'll obviously be against Florida. It'll be the first against the launch tonight. Sawyer getting around, gets in front, and Queener cut off every angle possible. So now let's find out what this penalty is going to be.
Yeah, they're
going
to get Kevin Crowley on a cross check from behind. Come down on House, gets a little high up by his neck, rides up. Easy call to make there. House, a little shifty midfielder. Smart play there, drawing the flag.
So that is just our second penalty. One each, and you see Crowley will sit it out now. The only other penalty we had ended up being a goal for the launch.
And I think Kevin's still trying to get his sea legs in the field for his field game, you know, just completing a whole season of indoor lacrosse.
When you're talking about a difference in an atmosphere from indoor to outdoor, when you're going into an oven like it is tonight, humidity-wise. Temperature not as high as it could be here, low 80s, but that 90% humidity is a drainer. This is White working into the middle. Could not hang on to it. A surprising mistake made that time by Cummings. And Brett Queener happily gets rid of the ball. And he'll get a little sigh of relief down there at the other end. That's big.
That could be huge. That was point blank. He catches that. He's got a point blank shot on Brett.
10.5 to go in this fourth quarter. And I suspect we'll see quite a bit of Casey Powell for the rest of the game. Garrett Thule just scored that last goal for the launch, and spectacular shot. He took one right to the face. The shot to the face by Dylan Ayers.
Yeah, drew the penalty there.
Yep, definitely. Thule spinning, firing, missing. I don't know if somebody got a piece of that in front or if it just bounced and Bassett was able to get it. That was a very clear penalty. I doubt that was intentional, but that's okay. That's not.
He's such a big man, and he's so strong, and he's got great stick skills. You have to honor him. He's going to bring that defensive pressure and was right there able to draw a penalty for his team.
So out of St. John's, Dylan Ayers.
Number 25, Dylan Ayers.
By the way, speaking of St. John's, the launch may be getting a St. John's product on their team as early as next week.
Yeah, we'll see. Tomorrow night is the NCAA selection show for NCAA Division I lacrosse and see if St. John's gets in or not. And if not, I'm sure we'll be seeing Curry and McArdle here next year, next week.
Number one draft pick for the launch. Opportunity here. Try to bounce it home and missed wide. Launch one for one in power play opportunities, and that one missing high. Ground ball scooped. Oh, good effort that time. Couldn't find it right away, and the launch come away with it. But Florida had a good chance. Couldn't. So neither team taking advantage of power play opportunities.
Big turnover there by the launch. Definitely Charlotte dodged a bullet.
Under 9 minutes remaining.
You want to play aggressive. You don't want to go back on your heels if you're Florida.
So these teams able to take care of the penalties. This is House. As it's season opening here, and here comes another flag. This will be another penalty on Florida. House taken down right before the box. That is not being received with open arms, and this might be Amadon is trotting off. It is definitely Amadon. We'll see if he's the one who's going to be sent to the penalty chair. I want to call it a box. It's just a chair.
Well, House is not getting his goals that he would like to, I'm sure, but he's certainly doing his job drawing penalties for his teammates.
Like the call?
I do.
So Amadon will sit. Charlotte goes back on the power play. So suddenly the officials in the fourth quarter brought out the flags, but both look like pretty well. We've had pretty clear calls here. So it's a 30-second power play for the Hounds. And a little lapse in concentration that time.
And look for a potential two-point shot here from Danowski or Sawyer on this power play.
No waiting for somebody to really uncork one here. And there's Danowski. And they're guarding it. Here he goes! And Queener anticipated it and made a great save. Well, you call that one, Kevin.
Big save. And Brett knew that too, obviously. So he's prepared. He read the scouting report.
Six goals scored from the two-point line last year by Danowski. So everybody around MLL should be aware of it. And you can, if you don't, maybe you can find out on Facebook. Go to facebook.com/Major League Lacrosse and get all your league news on Facebook. So we're covered in the social media world with Twitter and Facebook. Now we got to get Kevin Finneran more active on Twitter. That's our next goal for MLL fans. Big hit that time put on by McCormick, number 42, and the ground ball picked up by the Hounds, under 7.5 remaining. Only one goal in this quarter, and that one by Florida. Charlotte has never had a lead. They've been able to make comebacks as Sawyer missing on that shot. Florida's largest lead in this game has just been 2. So you can imagine the intensity picking up even more as these players probably get a little bit tired in this draining humidity.
No rush, plenty of time, Charlotte. One goal game, nothing in this league.
Kind of a sloppy pass here. Trepuka's going to have to chase it down, giving up a little bit of real estate and time. Trepuka, though, charging in and withdrawing as he looks for help. Gibbons working it around to Joe Cummings. Cummings. House. Being marked by Leo Gosney. Cameron Leo Gosney, because his brother Roman is also on the team. Just inside the two-point line. That missed everything, and Brett Queener either giving encouragement or criticism to one of his teammates. Gibbons will start things off again. And a shot clock at 1.
Yeah. Wise just to drop it, which he does. Yeah. And Charlotte's really been playing like 3, maybe 4 midfielders the whole game offensively, along with the 3 attackmen. And you wonder if this, you know, the Florida temperature might be paying some dividends for the hometown team.
Queener will lead the attack. Even with just the differential of 1 goal, he's going to be aggressive. And we have a timeout My time, says the official. Brett Queener, very animated, giving some instructions to his teammates. The official is just making sure they have this right. We may have had a timeout called here. Certainly Mike Serino, the Charlotte coach, would like to know what the call is and who's got the ball. And so would we. And the answer is the Launch have the ball. Leo Gosney has it. Roman Leo Gosney.
Just the stop is now clearing out the box, trying to get things straightened over by the scorekeeper's table. All kinds of Launch and Hounds in there. And Zebras don't like that. They want that place all to themselves.
So our officiating crew hopefully satisfied with the way everything has turned out.
Changing the shot clock time as well, so that was the initial issue.
And it's back to 45.
Another 10 seconds for the Launch there added.
And you can hear timeout. Stan Ross calling for a timeout that time. So with 5:24 to go, the Launch leading 8-7, trying to get their first win in Florida. They were in Hamilton, Ontario, Canada a season ago. Now they're down in a much different environment in every way you can imagine and trying to pick up that inaugural win. It's 8-7. We'll take a short break and return the MLL YouTube Game of the Week.
Yo, touch the future, baby.
The 2014 Major League Lacrosse Championship Game, August 23rd, Kennesaw, Georgia. Tickets are on sale now.
So, Brett Queener, we talked quite a bit earlier in the broadcast about Pierce Bassett, the goaltender for the Hounds, but Brett Queener for Florida certainly doing an outstanding job tonight after not finishing the game last week, suffering an injury to his right hand when he took a shot, and a vicious shot that knocked him out of the game. Queener with 15 saves tonight.
Anytime you have an 8-7 game with 5 minutes left in Major League Lacrosse, the goaltenders are doing an amazing job.
And a goal, and once again a spinning shot, and that looks like Thule again. Man, he is deadly on that side. That's a hat trick for him.
Garrett Thule just taking this Florida team, putting on his back. A lot of these defenders aren't used to him in his game.
They better learn fast.
Especially from the midfield position.
Launch goal.
It's obviously a great decision there by Coach Ross to bump him up to the midfield area, get him in front of the goal.
Well, now can the Launch defense hold a two-goal lead? They have not always been able to do it, in part because of the gigantic face-off advantage for the Hounds tonight. 13 out of 19, Charlotte has won. And they pick up their 14th out of 20. Charlotte has outshot Florida as well. There's the 23rd shot, and Queener comes away with it and starts the other way for Florida. And with 4.5 minutes to go, he knows the situation well. He's not going to try anything crazy here. And Woodson casually leaves it aside.
Don't bank on that.
Well, he is a goalie. Good point. And if you saw the halftime interview, you don't know what he's going to do. Casey Powell. That's Jason Noble for the launch, number 45. I think that's a 45.
Again, Josh Amadon.
No, it's Amadon. You're right, 15. Again, the uniform's a little tricky to read. Opportunity there in front. Powell scores! I don't know if it's a dagger goal by the launch, but Casey Powell just continuing to add to his burgeoning point total.
Well, the low-scoring nature of this game so far, it certainly could be a dagger. Obviously, Charlotte's got the firepower and the two-point capability, but that's a big one. Crowley goes hard, takes a shot, it goes awry, and Casey just has the wherewithal, calmness, and patience to bury it.
So Casey Powell, with two goals tonight and two assists. And this is the largest lead of the night. We'll break and we'll find out if the Hounds can make the comeback here in our YouTube MLL Game of the Week.
Championship game, August 23rd, Kennesaw, Georgia. Get your tickets to like speed? Check out the MLL All-Star Game Fastest Shot Competition.
Topped it, 114.
Can anyone top 114? Find out at halftime of the 2014 MLL All-Star Game, Thursday, June 26th at Harvard Stadium. For tickets and information, log on to MajorLeagueLacrosse.com.
I think that's a great idea. There's your score with 3:57 remaining in our game and a hat trick tonight for the attacker from the Army, Garrett Thule.
Garrett just starting off his sophomore campaign on a strong note. Again, taking the team on his back. You know, you'll know where he's going. You know he's going to want to come back to his left. But as any crafty shooter, you can tell, he gets it off. And when he does, when he has that time and room and hands free, doesn't matter where he is, what kind of angle is. He's just so big and strong and powerful. And with a 95-mile-an-hour shot, it's tough to stop.
So Thule, a 5-hour energy shot of the game, or in this case, shots of the game.
Number 22, Casey.
And Casey Powell, they call it a hat trick, but he's got two tonight. But Powell continues to rack up the points. So now the launch, and they win the faceoff, which they have done a distinct minority of the time tonight, but they pick up a big faceoff, further hurting Charlotte's chances to make a comeback. So you wonder about the Hounds, only 8 goals last week against Ohio, now just 7 this week against the launch, and they may have some offensive deficiencies. Now the launch, understandably, being extremely patient here. They're going to use much of that 60-second shot clock as they possibly can. Powell quickly getting rid of it as the launch sharing very nicely. Good teamwork, and they throw it away. The announcer Jinx comes to play again.
Nice rotation there by Charlotte's defense, causing a turnover. See what they can do on this transition play.
But as we say in the broadcast business, Kevin, they killed some good time. And that's exactly what Florida did. Took it to under 3 minutes before the Hounds could get an opportunity here. That's Jake Trapuka. And it looks like we're going to get a timeout. Probably called by Charlotte, head coach Charlotte. Mike Sereno. This is a team that went oh so close. They were the team that knocked Denver out of the playoff picture a year ago after the Outlaws were undefeated, and then they get to within a goal of Chesapeake before they fall short. And now they're having a little bit of trouble to put the ball in the net. By the way, Chesapeake leads the Lizards 10-7 in the fourth quarter. Now, the Hounds started slowly last year, too. They were 1-3 before they started to play better.
Yeah, and, you know, I mean, they're missing a couple of key players, but what they have out there now is the majority of their team with, you know, Donowski and Sawyer, Hawkins, their close defense led by Schmidt, you know. So I know Adam Gittleman, their goaltender, is a real big spark and fire plug for them and leader. So I'm sure they're anxious to get back him, although, again, 10 goals led up by a goalie is not a bad job by Pierce Bassett.
No, he started very, very well, and we talked about both these goaltenders tonight. Pierce Bassett for Charlotte in the white, he was unbelievable in the first quarter.
Again, Florida could have probably 3, 4, 5 more goals. Kept him in going there.
And let's not forget about his physical opposite, Brett Queener.
Obviously, a special game so far by Brett Queener. Inside the goal, outside of the goal, communicating, you know, just giving them a spark when they needed it most. Extremely emotional goalie, as you can tell.
Yeah, you think? Enjoying his Van Halen, as we all do, those of us who were around when Van Halen was popular. He wasn't. 2:41 remaining as Florida trying to get their first win as the Florida launch. They were a good franchise in Hamilton. Interesting that both games in the league right now are at 10-7. Chesapeake leading New York and Florida in front of Charlotte.
Be interesting to see if Charlotte sets up for a two-pointer early, or if they try to chisel away one goal at a time here.
Stan Ross having a calm discussion. That's actually not Stan. Stan's in a white hat. He's wearing the good guy hat. One of his assistants having a little conversation with the officials. And here we go. And Charlotte manufactures some instant offense against a launch defense that's played considerably better than a week ago against the Outlaws. Opportunity here, and it misses. Oh, it goes! It goes! I thought it was going to be high, but Matt Donowski comes through with a big goal for the Charlotte Hounds. It's 10-8.
And a real good decision there by a wily veteran. Scored a number of goals in this league. One of the best offensive players. Could have gone for the two early. Saw him hitch back a little bit. Made a wise decision.
Well, Donowski didn't have a goal last week in the loss to Ohio. He now has 3 tonight. Thought for a second he was going to try that two-pointer. You've talked about his accuracy with that. So hang on a second here. Florida won a big faceoff, and then ground ball. Who's got it? Florida. But Josh Hawkins is slashing away at it. Can't come up with it. These two teams. Hawkins, number 3 in white, trying to come away with it. You can see Amadon fighting with it for Florida. And coming away with it is Jake Smith for the Hounds. Under 2 minutes. And a timeout. Taken by Charlotte.
Great scrum there. Both teams had an opportunity to get the ball numerous times. Smith came up, huge ground ball.
So it's still going to be nervous time for the Florida launch. 1:52 to go to protect a 2-goal lead against a team that's been making comebacks all night long. We'll step aside on the MLL YouTube Game of the Week. All right, Charlotte is out of timeouts. Mike Serino has used them both up. He's got a 152 to come up with a big comeback. His team down 10-7. Earlier, they pick up the goal from Matt Donowski to make it 10-8, and they have the ball. And Queener with a save, shot right at him and by from Jake Tripucka. Roman Leo Gosney got a chance here if he wants to take it. He does it, scores! I guess he had a decision to make there, Kevin. Do I just go ahead and circle around some more and kill time or fire away? And he made the decision to put the launch in front again by three.
Huge goal. It starts with, again, Brett Queener in goal. Big save, point blank on Tripucka. He really had a lot of time to look at that. And then Leo Gausner comes down, uses his athleticism, his speed. He scored multiple goals in college at Lehigh, so that's nothing new for him.
That's his first of this season. And it comes at a unbelievably big time for the launch. Now they're 97 seconds away from that franchise first victory in Florida. Fallon wins another faceoff for Charlotte. He has more than done his job tonight for the Hounds. Donowski.
Definitely got to look for the two-pointer now.
Yeah, he's your guy for that. If you're a Charlotte fan, here he goes. Winds up, fires, and Queener staggering around, but he makes the save. And Donowski unleashed a howitzer. And Florida now getting ever closer to be a big win. Improve them to 1-1 while dropping the Hounds to 0-2. The Ohio Machine coming in here next to take on the launch.
1 minute. And you really don't even need a shot. There's 35 in the shot clock. Play good, strong, smart offense. Roll it in the corner.
Hounds will be hosting the Bayhawks next week at their historic Memorial Stadium.
Looks like that's a directive from Coach Ross, too.
So under 30, so the launch. Getting great goaltending from Brett Queener. Improved defense, plus Garrett Thule's hat trick. Another solid night for Casey Powell with a couple of goals. And barring something really unusual here, it's going to be the first win for Florida. Chance for a two-pointer here. Nope, they don't take it. Moving in for the one. Try to get the one early. Was he in the crease? Yes. That goal is waved off. You could see it right there in the goaltender's area, and that will do it. So the Florida launch picks up the first win since they left Hamilton. They do it against the runners-up from the league last year, winning it 11-8. That man, your player of the game, Garrett Thule, with a hat trick tonight. And a big win for the fans here who didn't sit through the raindrops that we feared were going to affect the game. And it's a great win for Florida.
Yeah, it was a barn burner back and forth, and Florida pulled away at the end there. They really made the smarter plays, the better shooters. Really stepped up tonight, and they had some good ones.
You see Thule has some happy hugs for his performance from his teammates and handed him out as well. So a balanced night for Florida. Charlotte only really actually outshot the launch. At least we're waiting for the final stats to come in. But with about a minute to go, Charlotte had a 26-22 advantage. They had an advantage in ground balls, and they had a distinct advantage in faceoffs. But the one place where you have to have the advantage right there belongs to the Florida launch. Kevin and I will step aside and be back with more from the MLL YouTube Game of the Week. Okay. This telecast of Major League Lacrosse is presented by Coca-Cola. Open happiness. By Brine, proud to be an official equipment sponsor of the MLL. Brine, makers of the world's finest lacrosse gear. By Powerade, power through with Powerade Ion 4. And by 5-Hour Energy, for those who play for the love of the game. Stan Ross gets his first win in South Florida as the Launch defeat the Charlotte Hounds 11-8. Charlotte now 0-2 on the year. Florida improves to 1-1. Charlotte will be taking on the Bayhawks next week, and it will be Florida hosting the Ohio Machine, finishing off their three-game homestand. Kevin, what do you take out of this game?
Well, you know, it was a battle back and forth most of the game. You kind of had the feeling that, Florida had the momentum most of the game at certain times, key times. And you look at it from top to bottom, starting with their goaltender. You know, Greg Kreener had a great solid game. Their interior defense, Tucker Durkin in the midfield, you know, led by Garrett Thule and Crowley. And then, you know, Casey always taking control of the game when they need to. Charlotte played well. Obviously, they didn't accomplish some of the things they wanted. Double digits in goals, they still, without that, hold Thule and Crowley in check. Improve on the faceoffs, they did do that, but... You know, 0-2 is still 0-2, and that's a tough hole to fall out of in this league.
And Charlotte, although they started 1-3 last year, clearly 0-2 without having a lead in either game yet, either against Ohio last week or tonight against the Florida Launch. So they've got some work to do with a tough opponent coming into Charlotte on Saturday. And, of course, the Ohio Machine will be playing at Denver tomorrow, and they will be coming to South Florida next Saturday to take on the Launch. We'll return and come back with a man of the match. Garrett Thule will join us in a moment here on the MLL YouTube Game of the Week. Standing by here with Garrett Thule, we've named you the player of the game. A hat trick will do that. Let's talk for just a second about the approach tonight as opposed to last week. What was working well?
Well, this is actually my first week out, so, you know, we got things going in practice on the shoot-around. So, you know, we were just working on, you know, getting the short stick matchups going. So, you know, dodging hard to the right and working back to my strong hand to my left. And, you know, I kept working, so it was working for me. But, you know, the team was playing great. I mean, we had a lot of team chemistry. A few, you know, a few lapses there, but we got back after it.
I think the scouting report is out on you, by the way. It may not be as easy to get some of those shots off after what happened tonight.
No, yeah, I think they'll be ready to cover that next week.
Talk for a second about the importance of Casey Powell and what he can do, because all eyes certainly are going to be on him when he has the ball.
Absolutely. I mean, he's one of the best in the game, best he's ever been. So, I mean, he's definitely going to attract a lot of attention when he's out there, and he's out there to make everybody else better too.
Also, I thought tonight you had the Launch had a great performance from Brett Kuehner. Early on, Bassett played very well in goal for Charlotte, but Kuehner certainly came up with a ton of saves. Plus, he has that rather unusual approach of leading the attack himself sometimes.
Yeah, he does. Yeah, he's an awesome player. Everybody just feeds off him.
Well, congratulations, Garrett Thule, with a hat trick tonight. Good luck next week against Ohio.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks for coming up, making the trip up here also. Garrett Thule with three goals tonight in his MLL debut for the Florida Launch. We'll have some final thoughts when we return on the YouTube Game of the Week. Once again, our final score tonight, the Florida Launch defeats the Charlotte Hounds 11-8. For Kevin Finneran and our entire crew here in Boca Raton at FAU Stadium, I'm Dave Lamont. For highlights of this game and all your MLL video, subscribe to the MLL YouTube channel. And for all your Major League Lacrosse news, visit MajorLeagueLacrosse.com. This has been a presentation of Blacks United Marketing and Major League Lacrosse. Good night from South Florida.